Hello friends, today we are going to discuss about National Commission for Allied and Healthcare Profession Act 2021. I'm Dr. Suresh Padmat, Professor of Psychiatry, working at NIMHANS, Bangalore. Before I start my presentation, I would like to have a disclaimer. This presentation is for academic and training purpose only. If you want to have a legal opinion, please do contact an advocate. This presentation is not a substitute for professional legal opinion. Let's discuss about National Commission for Allied and Healthcare Profession Act 2021. In this video, I am going to introduce this legislation, what was the need for this legislation, and what are the salient points of this legislation. This video needs to be seen by those 56 healthcare professionals who are addressed in this legislation. And also, the people working in healthcare sector need to know about this legislation. And also to those students who are perceiving, who are planning to pursue in healthcare need to know about this legislation. Hence, stay tuned till the end. Let's discuss about healthcare ecosystem across the world. The healthcare system was challenged by COVID-19. It challenged not only the healthcare sector, healthcare professionals, administration, financial, and it challenged the developing country and developed countries. And it split open the differences between the haves and have-nots. The people who can access health, who cannot access health. And also, the weakness of our health system was split wide open. And whenever we talk about healthcare system, we think of only doctor and nurse. That is unfortunate. There are 56 different healthcare professions which is present across the world. Unfortunately, they have not been given due credit. Let's take an example of COVID. Before we say this person is COVID positive, they have to undergo RT-PCR test. Who is doing this test? Who is collecting the sample? Who is taking the sample? Who is dispatching this? How the reports are displayed? The whole thing requires various technologists. We call them also healthcare professionals. Since they are behind the scene, we cannot just ignore them. The COVID highlighted these differences. That means our healthcare sector is highly diversified and comprehensive. They are seen only in the corporate hospitals or in the tertiary care center. Unfortunately, in the rural sector, we don't find these healthcare professionals. These healthcare system, hence we can call it as highly fragmented, not only in India, across the world. Now it is the time to put all those fragments into a single piece to provide a holistic healthcare to our patients. To recognize all these 56 healthcare professionals, a new legislation was drafted. The reason was, we have councils, we have commissions for doctors, for nurses, pharmacists, and not for others. That means the 56 healthcare professions are not regulated, not been recognized, and not been given a platform since many decades. The Bohr committee also said this, that we need to train supporting staff. We need to have a platform for them. Yes, it was planned in 1994, the first legislation came into picture, but it did not see the light. In 2007, it was attempted, and even 2011, there were too many dissenting voices. There were too many noises. Unfortunately, that never took off. First time, a new legislation has been drafted. The new legislation has been given power to 56 healthcare professions. That legislation is National Commission for Allied and Healthcare Profession Act 2021. This legislation received the President's assent on 28 March 2021. This legislation has 8 chapters and 70 sections. Let's know why this legislation was implemented. This legislation was implemented with the preamble. The preamble is the one which gives the objective for this legislation. And this act provides regulation and maintenance of standards of education and services by allied and healthcare professionals. Let's spend some time on this first point. Basically, it says, till now, there is no regulation on the allied healthcare education and also healthcare professionals, apart from doctors and nurses and RCI and pharmacists. There is no other councils to monitor the education of these healthcare professionals, to look into their curriculum, to look into those institutions, to see what is the entry and exit exams. Nothing is there. Hence, this legislation will look into those regulation and maintenance of the standards of education. The second important is assessment of these institutions which are providing the degrees, to see what kind of these institutions are there, what is the staff structure, how they are providing the education, do they meet the minimum standards, how many students are intaken, and whether the student staff ratio is maintained. Maintenance of a register. Whoever gets this degree, they will get a registration. That registration is equivalent to doctor's registration, medical council registration. Similar, there will be a national medical commission for healthcare registration to occur here. That means they will be recognized across the country. Not only that, the creation of a system to improve access to research and development and adoption of latest scientific advancement. So these are the four important objectives have been kept under this legislation. And the matters which are related to this will be implemented through this legislation. The section 2 talks about the preliminary and the definitions. Let's know the definitions. The first and the foremost, what does it allied and healthcare professionals means? This allied and healthcare professional has two important professionals hidden under that. The two important professionals are allied health professionals, healthcare professionals. These are the two important professionals have been subsumed under the whole legislation. Let's define each one of this legislation. Let's define the allied health professionals first. Allied health professional means this definition has two important components. One is the technical component and the educational qualification required component. Let's look into the first, the technical component. Allied health professional technical component is this includes an associate or a technician or a technologist who is trained to perform any technical and practical task to support, the word please remember, to support diagnosis, treatment of illness, disease, injury or impairment. And to support again, support the implementation of any healthcare treatment and referral plan recommended by a doctor or a medical or a nursing or any other health professionals. That means the technical component is to support the diagnosis and treatment, and also to support the implementation of any healthcare plan planned or the referral. But however, there is educational component also. The educational component clearly says that it can be either a diploma or a degree which lasts for 2000 hours spread over a period of 2 to 4 years divided into various semesters. Dear friends, please remember this whole definition mirrors the national education policy. The policy was done at the same time, now the legislation echoes the policy, national education policy. That means there is a need for skill transference, and that is the reason 2000 hours have been clearly said for allied health professionals. This is the definition of allied health professionals. Let's look into the definition of healthcare professionals. Again, the healthcare professional has two important components. One is technical component and the educational component. The technical component means healthcare professionals includes scientist, therapist or other professionals who studies, advises, researches, supervises or provides preventive, curative, rehabilitative, therapeutic or promotional health services. So this is the technical component. However, the educational component is very stringent. It clearly said it should be degree and it should have 3600 hours spread over a period of 3 to 6 years divided into various semesters. So dear friends, allied is to support. Healthcare professionals are directly involved with the patient, either in prevention, curative, rehabilitative or therapeutic process. And the duration is 3600 hours spread over a period of 3 to 6 years. That is what is healthcare professional definition means. This is the qualification. the qualification which is required should be regular learning mode. It can't be distance education mode. That is how I can understand and interpret this legislation. Regular learning mode means in person. The skill transference occurs usually in the in-person regular learning mode. Hence, it has to be in person. Coming to the institutions. The institutions are basically educational or research institution which grants diploma or undergraduate or postgraduate or doctoral degree or any other post degree certificates in an allied and healthcare professions under this act. So these are these institutions which are defined, needs to be registered under the legislation, and also minimum standards, what is the staff pattern, how the courses have been considered and how do they function, and where is the institution set up. All those regulation and minimum standards will be set for these institution, and these institutions will be regulated under this legislation. Now, what they can do under these healthcare professionals, what they can do, what is their role? That has been clearly said in task shifting. Task shifting means the process whereby specific tasks are moved where appropriate to related allied and healthcare professionals specialized in those tasks by reorganizing the healthcare work efficiently for improved healthcare. That means this legislation also clearly says that what they can do and what they cannot do. That will be clearly mentioned under the task shifting. And clearly remember that there will be various categories which are recognized, and they are placed into the schedule. That schedule use is there under the end of the legislation. Under this schedule, there are 10 recognized categories. These categories, 10 categories, is going to encompass 56 healthcare professions. Not only that, these each allied and healthcare professions are coded as per the ILO, International Labour Organization's International Standard Classification of Occupations, are coded here, so that even if they go out of India, they will be recognized, and the terminology of the occupation is well known across the world. Those have been clearly mentioned under the legislation. And these 10 categories are Medical Laboratory and Life Sciences, Trauma, Burn Care and Surgical Anesthesia Technology, Physiotherapy Professionals, Nutrition Science Professionals, Ophthalmic Science Professionals, Occupational Therapy Professionals, Community Care, Behavioral Health Science and Other Professionals, Medical Radiology, Imaging and Therapeutic Technology Professionals, Medical Technologists and Physician Associates, Health Information Management and Health Informatics Professionals. So these are the 10 categories which are recognized under the legislation, and these 10 categories will have 10 councils. These councils will say what is the minimum standard for each legislation and what should be the duration and what should be the curriculum and how the entry and exit exams will be conducted. So 10 councils will be formed under this legislation to monitor these 10 categories and 56 healthcare professions. But however, Section 7 clearly says that the central government can amend this list. They can add more healthcare professionals, they can remove, because healthcare profession is highly fluid, highly dynamic, and every day it is growing at the rapid pace. Hence, to include various other healthcare professionals which are coming will be amended as per the Section 70. Let's look into the various statutory bodies under the legislation. First and the foremost, there is National Commission for Allied and Healthcare Profession. This is the national body as a commission which has chairperson and various other members. This is at the center, and also this will be assisted by 10 professional councils at this point of time. Along with this 10 professional councils, we also have National Allied and Healthcare Advisory Council. This council consists of Central National Commission body members, that is chairperson and vice chairperson, and also from the State Health Commission. That is, from the state also, every chairperson becomes the member of this advisory council. So there is a coordination between the National Commission and the State Council. This is at the national level, but at the state level, State Allied Healthcare Council will be formed. Each state will have one council, and this council will be responsible for implementation of the legislation through four boards. These four boards are: one is UG, Allied and Healthcare Educational Board, that is undergraduate Allied and Healthcare Educational Board, Postgraduate Allied and Healthcare Educational Board, Allied and Healthcare Professional Assessment and Rating Board, and also Ethics and Registration Board. These four boards will assist the State Allied and Healthcare Council to implement this legislation. The national level is more of advisory, making rules, sending notification. It's the implementation part is very less at the national level. The state has to take responsibility, and the state will play a major role under this legislation through these four boards. At the same time, the state can also have various advisory councils depending upon the number, how many ever they want. My dear friends, the state has to play a huge role here now. Let's look into the National Commission for Allied and Healthcare Profession, which is the only apex body which is there with regard to this legislation. This is there from section 3 to 9, which has a constitution and composition of this commission. This commission has one chairperson, one vice chairperson, ex officio members, that is, I think 5 to 6, a joint secretary from various ministries will be there, and also biennial rotation of ex officios, 4 members will be there, part-time members of the commissions will be there, 2 persons from charitable institution will be there, and at least this commission will meet once in 4 months. Function of this commission. This commission will look into the education. What is the curriculum? How the education is set? How many hours they are providing the education? And what is the course? At the same time, it will look into the professional services. What services they have to learn? What is the core competencies? How this profession will be regulated? At the same time, professional conduct, code of ethics and etiquettes will be monitored. If there is any complaint, it will be looked after by the ethics board. They will register the allied healthcare professionals will be registered both in the center and the state. Once they are registered in the center state, the name goes to the central also. Scope of practice will be discussed. Institution standards who are providing these degrees will be looked after it. Each course standards will be set up. Entry and exit exams will be clearly monitored. That is about the National Commission. Now moving to the Professional Council. There will be 10 professional councils which will be formed, which have not less than 4 members and not more than 24 members will be there. And each council will have a president and a member. And each council will look into their respective professions. These professions which are mentioned under their category. And representing each profession, recognized categories, these members will also be placed. And this council will play a major role in monitoring that particular profession. Moving to the National Allied and Healthcare Advisory Council. This is a single council body which is there, comprising of both national body and also the state council. This has a chairperson from the National Commission and also vice chair from the National Commission and some members. However, the other members are chairperson of each state council and also the principal secretary dealing with the medical education in every state and union territory will be called here. My dear friends, the union territory will not come under the central here. They will come under the respective state. For example, Pondicherry will be, also called as Puducherry, will be monitored by State of Tamil Nadu Council. So this is how this has been planned. Coming to the State Allied and Health Council. This State and Allied Healthcare Council will be again formed by chairperson, vice chairperson, and the state has to form this council to monitor the implementation of this legislation. The important implementing agency is State Council. This will look into the education, professional services, professional code and conduct and ethics and etiquettes, registering the professionals, scope of practice, institution standards, giving registration to these institutions. Each course standards will be looked into it. Entry and exit exams will be conducted by the council under the guidance of the National Commission. So these are the important state councils which is going to play a role. Further, there will be 4 autonomous boards will be formed under the legislation at each state. That means every state will have 4 boards. One is Undergraduate Allied and Healthcare Education Board, Postgraduate Allied and Health Education Board, at the same time Assessment and Registration Board, And finally, Professions Ethics and Registration Board. These four boards will play a crucial role in implementing the legislation. And some of the chapters are recognition and reciprocity. Basically, if a person has done his education or academics from the outside the country, what should be the regulation for them, how they will be registered, what exam they should take. And similarly, if a Indian origin person has taken the qualification from abroad, if he comes back, how you will be registered will be monitored here. At the same time, if a country with the bilateral MOU is going to sign a memorandum of understanding with the government of India, their allied healthcare professional will be recognized under our country, and our allied healthcare professionals' registration will be recognized by those country under the recognition and reciprocity chapter. This is a wonderful clause which has been put here in this legislation. Not only that, registration of the institutions will be coming under the state council, and they are going to register after doing inspection, whether they look into the whether they have a minimum standards fulfilled, what is the staffing pattern, what is the number of students intake, and how the courses are administered, what is the curriculum, they will look into that. At the same time, registration of each allied healthcare professionals also will be done at the state council. And each state council will update, and the national level online central registry will be made available across the country for each states. At the same time, this legislation is serious, and they bring in very serious offenses, penalties for whoever contravenes the law. First and the foremost is under section 56, if a person is going to practice without registration for the first time, 50,000 rupees will be the fine. If he continues to do for the second time, 6 months imprisonment with or without fine up to 1 lakh will be given. Coming to the section 57, if he misuses the title of the paramedicals or these allied healthcare professionals title, if he's misusing for the first time, 1 lakh rupees will be fine will be given. For the second time, if he continues to do it, 1 year imprisonment with or without 2 lakh rupees fine will be given to that person. In section 58, if his person's name has been removed from the registry and he does not submit his certificate back to the council, the state council, he will be first time, he will be asked to give 50,000 rupees. And if he does not submit back his certificate, every day he has to pay 5,000 rupees fine. Till the day he submits, he has to pay those fine of 5,000 rupees per day. Under section 59, whoever contravenes the law, the imprisonment up to 1 to 3 years is there, with or without fine up to 1 lakh to 5 lakh rupees has been mentioned under this legislation. But however, there are a lot of grey areas at this point of time. There are many dissenting voices regarding this legislation. Please do not judge this legislation. Of course, you may think of a best legislation, but at this point of time, we have a good legislation. The best should not become the enemy of the good. Still, there is a long way to go. We have to now draft the rules, regulations, state rules has to come in, minimum standards have to put in, the council has to be set up, educational institutions need to be revised, need to be inspected, how the education is going across the country needs to be studied, ethics guidelines has to be drafted for each professions, notification has to be done, and this requires time and requires the commitment from the each state. It is the political will and the efforts and the emotional investment done by each state will play a role. If a state implements this legislation very first, those healthcare workers will be recognized across the country, not only across the country, across the world. To conclude, my dear friends, right to access for healthcare is required to the grassroots level, at the same time at the tertiary level also. For this, we require allied and healthcare professionals. These are 56 professions which are there in our country. They need to be given a platform, a registry. They need to be regulated, not only the institution and also the profession. And this legislation is going to give this regulatory body at the state level. And the state is going to implement this legislation. And this is a landmark legislation which is going to make a paradigm shift in providing care from individual care to individual-based, doctor and nurse-based care to a holistic team-based approach care. And this legislation ensures the platform, recognition to regulate the institution, registration of this institution, ranking of these institutions. At the same time, it will regulate both undergraduate and postgraduate curriculum and also those courses. And also it will register the registration of the professionals and also looks into the professional ethics. Thank you very much for giving your valuable time. Stay safe.